On behalf of the Hodges University Board of Trustees and our administrators, faculty, and staff, welcome to the 33rd Annual Commencement Ceremony. I'm Dr. John Meyer, President of Hodges University, and today is a day to recognize and celebrate the accomplishments of the class of 2022. To get to this point, these graduates had to take time away from their families and friends to do homework, write papers, study for exams, and complete other projects necessary to graduate. Many of our graduates did this while taking care of family and while working. And ultimately, this journey has been an investment in themselves to help make a brighter future. It also serves to inspire those around them that with determination and grit, they too can reach their goals. Commencement is my favorite day of the year. There is nothing more satisfying than shaking the hands of our graduates and congratulating them on a job well done. I'm proud to say that I'm a two-time graduate of Hodges University, so I've crossed the stage to receive my diplomas, and I know the doors that can be opened for you. And that's what all of us here at Hodges University want more than anything else, the success of our students who now join the more than 14,000 alumni who've made a positive impact on our community and beyond. Congratulations, class of 2022.
It all started humbly enough in 1990 when Hodges University, then known as International College, began with just 85 students in a plaza in East Naples. 2 years later, a branch campus opened in Fort Myers and expanded to include English as a second language program. The need for higher education focused on adult learners continued to grow. And in 2000, we built campuses in Naples, and in 2012, in Fort Myers. In 2007, a prominent and well-respected couple invested in the college to further expand its offerings and reach for adult learners. Earl and Thelma Hodges made a significant gift, and the college was renamed Hodges University in their honor. Entrepreneur and businessman, while Thelma was the fourth nurse hired at Naples Community Hospital.
That was when the war was on and they were giving scholarships and all. And so I said I'll just go be a nurse. And that was how it came about. All told, I think I had 31 years in nursing. But the patient care is very important, but you have to love it.
As the needs for the community grow and change, so too have the programs offered at Hodges University. One of the many benefits of being a private, nonprofit university is the ability to quickly offer programs that train students to become the professionals we need. Students can attend classes on campus, live online, or online while they reach their goal to become the business professional, entrepreneur, accountant, computer expert, mental health counselor, digital designer, finance expert, paralegal, marketer, organizational manager or leader, or healthcare hero. They can earn professional certifications, associate, bachelor's, or master's degrees.
This is a very exciting day. We're here to celebrate the future.
Honoring our new president, or relatively new president, Dr. Meyer.
This is a really exciting day for us at Hodges University, and it's just wonderful to be surrounded by my colleagues as we all celebrate a new chapter in our community.
It's a big day. It's a great day.
In 2017, the Hodges University Board of Trustees appointed Dr. John Meyer as the university's fifth president. Dr. Meyer truly understands the challenges of Hodges University students and the balancing act that many have with working full-time and raising families.
He is one of our students, our past student, so he understands us and he knows what we're doing here, what we want to do.
He is a two-time graduate of Hodges University, an achievement reached while working full-time and raising a family. His vision is laser focused on certifications and degrees that directly lead to an in-demand career. In 2018, Hodges University rededicated its Dr. Peter Thomas Veterans Services Center, named for Peter Thomas, a U.S. Army and World War II veteran. This center serves the nearly 20% of our students who are active duty or military veterans. It's overseen by Hodges University staff, who are also military veterans.
We do have veteran staff members, and almost all of our veteran staff members are students who were here at the university. So we know firsthand what those struggles are and what it's like, and we've been through that process. So I think the greatest resource we have for the students is our staff here at Hodges.
It's a place where we help them navigate the transition from military to civilian and academic life. They share a special camaraderie that's encouraged in the center. In 2020, Hodges University invested over $3.5 million to renovate Building U on the Fort Myers campus. It's now the modern health sciences building, which is home to state-of-the-art simulation labs and classrooms for students training to become the nurses, the physical therapist assistants, the EMTs, the paramedics, the dental assistants, and the dental hygienists our community needs. In 2023, Hodges University Dental Clinic will open to serve the residents of our region. Since those early days, there are now over 14,000 graduates of Hodges University. They are the professionals in our community, our state, our nation, and our world. Looking to the future, Hodges University will continue evolving to provide the pathways to career success. As you watch the Hodges University commencement ceremony and cheer for your graduate, you may notice several elements and wonder what they mean. As the ceremony begins, you'll see the chair of the Hodges University Board of Trustees lead the procession carrying the mace. Did you know this tradition began in the 15th century as a military tool? The king's bodyguard carried the mace as he walked in front of the ruler. Today, the mace is a symbol of the arrival of university officials. The Hodges University mace is made of wood, which symbolizes strength, warmth, generosity, and idealism. It features the university seal and the tassels that are the university's colors of navy blue and coral red. You'll see President Meyer wearing the presidential chain of office. There are only two times he wears this, for inauguration and commencement. Like the mace, the presidential chain is also a medieval tradition that was eventually adopted in Europe and the United States. It symbolizes leadership and authority. The Hodges University Presidential Chain of the Office features a medallion with the university's seal. The links were designed for longevity, as each president will have his or her name engraved on a link along with his or her years of service. Dr. Meyer is the fifth name to be engraved on the chain. Have you ever wondered what the banners in a commencement ceremony are called? They are gonfalons, often in a shield shape that hang from a crosspiece pole. They bear the colors of the university and are used to represent the different schools within. At Hodges University, there are five schools, plus English as a second language. Each school gonfalon bears the official Hodges University seal, plus three stripes in colors that represent degrees awarded within the school. The English as a second language gonfalon has three stripes in blue, the color used for the United Nations. The gowns or robes you see faculty and graduates wearing are filled with symbolism. They also include hoods, headwear, and other adornments. Depending on the degree earned, the regalia will have variations in the sleeves. Bachelor's degree gowns are worn closed with square sleeves. The master's gowns can be worn open or closed, and the sleeves are oblong. Doctoral gowns have bell sleeves with three velvet bands. The coloring and size of the hood directly represent the type of degree earned and the colors of the institution where it was awarded. The symbol most commonly used to represent graduation is the cap or mortarboard cap. It's made with the same material as the gown or robe. The exception is the doctoral cap. The tassel, which hangs from the mortarboard cap, is worn on the right side for commencement. President Meyer will tell undergraduates to move their tassels to the left near the end of the ceremony to signify they have graduated. For graduate students, in our case, those earning master's degrees, the tassel remains on the left side throughout the ceremony. You'll see many Hodges University graduates also wearing medals or medallions, which are worn around the neck, and honor cords for academic achievement, or red, white, and blue cords, which represent military veteran status. So when you see the mace, gonfalons, the presidential chain, robes, mortarboard caps, medallions, and cords, you'll know what they symbolize. Study hard. There will be a test later. After all, this is a university.
So I think the most satisfying part about or seeing my students go through the program is to actually watch the light bulb go off and them actually have aha moments when they start placing what they learned in the classroom, their knowledge and their skills, and they put it in real life clinical situations with their patients. And that aha moment is probably the most satisfying to me.
Well, the most satisfying part for me is when they get to the program and with no knowledge, no background of the language or anything, then they complete the program and then they're able to communicate, get better jobs. Some of them get promotions at work.
One of the most satisfying aspects is when I actually see an accident at a street corner, and you know, when we all pass by, we all rubberneck the situation, and it's such satisfaction seeing one of the students that have been through our paramedic class at that scene taking care of the patient. That's just heartwarming.
I think the most rewarding part about this is being able to help veteran students throughout their transition out of the military. It's extremely difficult, especially for people who've served 20 years, to start this new chapter of their life when all they know is military. So being able to be a part of that transition from start to finish and watching them graduate and move forward with the next part of their careers is probably the most rewarding experience ever.
The fact that Hodges University has only been around since 1990, in those 30-some years, that we now have 14,000 individuals who have graduated here. And our very first class of individuals are at the point now they're contemplating retirement, and so we have the full gamut of those who are ready to retire and those who are just beginning their careers anew. And so having the opportunity to meet individuals who across, you know, all breadths and aspects of their careers is really satisfying, and just to see the type of the impact that Hodges has had on them and hopefully will continue to have on our newest graduates.
It's more their contribution to the health and wellness of the community that they're serving.
The most satisfying thing about my role here at Hodges is knowing that the money that we raise through events and through individual donations goes to help students complete their degree through financial aid assistance.
I just love how connected everybody is. You know, the fact that it's not yet a huge university where everybody doesn't know each other's names, just the fact that everybody, when they pass each other, they know each other. It just has such a local and friendly feel to it.
I think my favorite part of being on the trustees is seeing the really innovative things that the faculty and staff are doing with the university. I think it's a gem of a institution within our community, and they've really done a phenomenal job of putting together programs that are much needed for our businesses and that lead to jobs and careers. And I think that's the most important part.
Learning the different students' lives and how we help them, that is the most rewarding part, when we see that these have changed somehow their lives.
Make home and work and school all mesh together. It's very, very difficult, and when they're able to be successful at that and they make it through it, it's rewarding. And to see them walk across that stage, they did it, and it's a very proud moment.
For me, teaching and learning is key to everything that we do here at Hodges. And working with faculty, we can make that happen, improve students' life.
The proudest moment is when I see 24 students take the test and 24 students pass the test.
I think the proudest moment I have is when the alumni take their board exams and they pass.
Knowing that, you know, from the bottom up, helping improve our community, because everything, all of the world's problems and our communities included, are solved with education. And so, you know, helping build that is near and dear to me, and the least I can do to give back.
Seeing the changes that we make in people's life here at Hodges, and the way how they celebrate, those who come to see their walking on stage that day, is just priceless.
I think I enjoy seeing the confidence. You know, when you start something new, people are very tentative, but by the end, they walk out with this feeling of accomplishment and purpose.
Watching the graduates cross the stage as their family members scream out to them, you know, congratulations, mom, dad, or whomever it is, it's so great to hear that energy in the room.
I just love the excitement and to see the families being so proud of the students as they're walking across the stage.
The impact that the university is making on students' lives and on the community, like I said, it leads to jobs and careers that are much needed within our community. And I love to see that our students are thriving, and I love to see that there's that direct connection to opportunity here locally.
I have a very unique role because I'm the director of grants development, but also alumni relations. And because they're two very disparate functions, it gives me the opportunity, one, to work on the grants aspect to try to bring in funding and programs to benefit the university, but also in working with our alumni and having and providing an aspect and an avenue for those individuals who were here to stay engaged, to be involved, and to remain a part of the Hodges family.
I think the proudest part is knowing that a lot of universities really don't have a Veterans Services Center. Like a lot of universities, they do have a representative, but they don't have a designated space for their veteran students. So we are one of the few universities in the area, even throughout Florida, that has a vet center specifically for veteran students.
The best advice that I have for each and one of you graduates is to stay true to your values. Don't spend every waking hour at work. Go home. Spend time with your loved ones and make sure that you keep yourself safe. It's all worth it in the end, and the best of luck to you with all of your career and future educational goals.
Congratulations, graduates. I know how it feels to walk across that stage, and now it's your turn. I'm extremely proud of you, and Hodges is extremely proud of you.
For the class of 2022, on behalf of the Hodges University Alumni Association, congratulations from all of us here. We wish you the absolute best in whatever endeavors, in whichever direction life takes you. The best advice I can give you, the key to success, is perseverance.
Graduating class of 2022, congratulations. Remember that the learning continues, the learning does not stop here. So go out and apply what you have learned into your works, into your lives, but continue learning.
Graduation marks a beginning of a long journey ahead of you. It's time now to put in practice everything that you learned, and let's not forget, this is just the beginning. Keep fighting, keep pursuing your dreams.
Don't lose your critical thinking skills that you've learned here at Hodges. It's most important to remain open-minded and keep the research going.
You're always going to learn something every single day, and don't be afraid to learn something new.
Don't lose hope. Don't just never get tired. Keep trying, because you will get there. Look around you. You are not alone. There are hundreds like you. Congratulations.
Congratulations, class of 2022. I wish you all the best in your future endeavors, and I look forward to staying in touch with you as new Hodges alumni.
Dream big.
You got this.